In the Factor follow-up segment tonight, the Veterans Affairs scandal, a shocking new audit by the VA shows the situation at its hospitals across the country is even worse than previously thought. It discovered that hundreds of thousands more veterans than first reported are having to wait at least a month just to secure a medical appointment. It's an unbelievable mess. So what should we do to clean it up? Joining us now, television personality and veterans advocate, Mr. Montel Williams. Montel, you've been a very, very outspoken advocate. What's going on? What do we do? What are your thoughts? You call it a VA surge. What's
we
that?
Need a VA surge, I'm going to tell you. So all of your viewers, please go up on Montel_Williams and just go hashtag VA surge. I have a petition at the White House asking the president to stop and listen to this. In the last 2 days, have you not heard the President of the United States say, we are going to surge if necessary, when he gave the award, the Medal of Honor yesterday, when he was given the recipient the Medal of Honor? He talked about the fact that he was injured in the surge. He keeps using this as a term for us to send more children off to die. If we're going to send them off to die, why don't we surge to take care of them right now while they're here at home? And this can get done. The problem is that we're bouncing this around. There are solutions to this problem.
It's not a money problem, though, is it?
No, there's plenty of money. The money, it's a leadership problem. There's no ifs, ands, or buts. It's a leadership problem. It's a regulation problem because we have civil servants who can't be fired. But we could still take care of this even in spite of that. You want me to tell you how?
Yeah.
Simply, right now, the president doesn't even need an executive order. He's the commander-in-chief. He can tell each head of the services, I want you to open up tomorrow. The SRBs, do you know what they are?
No.
They are soldier readiness, SRPs, soldier readiness processing centers. Mm-hmm. Before a soldier can go overseas to go to war, they send them into like a triage. They check everything about him like an oil check, right? They go in, Jiffy Lube, check them from top to bottom. If there's something wrong, they go to the hospital. If not, they go overseas to war. Right now, those centers are open around the country. We have DOD facilities here in the United States, open around the country. If we brought on enough staff to staff them, we could bring in VA soldiers.
Do we have the right people in place, Montel?
No,
I'm reading some study that showed 80% of the people in the Phoenix VA received incentive bonuses. 100% of the upper-level management across the VA received at least positive reinforcement at the end of the year. What's going on here?
What's going on here is the fact that we chopped off the head and thought we took care of the problem.
Shinseki.
That's right. The chicken's still running around and running around aimlessly. It's time to take the chicken down. And some of those people that are in staff that actually voted to give themselves bonuses for a rigged system that allowed them to lie, some people should go to jail. How come we're not hearing this? We can jump up and down tomorrow and say, let's send more boys off to die. But we can't jump up and down today to talk about how to take care of the ones that are here.
$400 million the VA paid out in incentive bonuses in 2013.
$400 million. Anybody who got a bonus, if it was based on the records that were fabricated, they should go to jail. Nobody's even talking about that. No prosecution. How can we right now today, guess what? Yesterday, the president said 550 soldiers are going to go on the ground, Marines going in right now to be a part of the extraction force. We're going to be sending planes above Iraq. And guess what? The bad guys just got Stinger missiles. They could bring a plane down. If a soldier gets injured today, tomorrow, are we going to live up to the promise that we made them, stating that we would take care of them no matter what?
Montel, how is the medical care at the VA?
Let me tell you something. There are people who wake up every single day that go to work that want to take care of our soldiers. You can go to some of these VA hospitals, you will see people on the ground busting their tails to help. Unfortunately, you have some lifelong career-minded people who have made the VA a career for themselves and even put bonuses in there at the end so they can make sure that they get some sort of exit pay for not doing their job. We need to change the VA,
let me summarize this. So the doctors and the nurses are good. There's plenty of money.
Plenty of money.
We just have an administration problem.
But guess what? We have an administration problem, a leadership problem within that administration. But guess what? This is really a logistics problem. I have a solution for you tomorrow. There's a gentleman by the name of Ken Fisher, mm-hmm. who's the president of the Fisher Foundation. You guys know
him well.
Runs the Fisher Foundation, Fisher Houses, right?
Yep.
He's built a Fisher House at almost every single VA hospital around the country. He's worked with the last four VA secretaries. This man knows more about the pain that families go through than any person that the president could appoint. Put him in charge right now. He wouldn't have wanted this job a year ago. I'm the one who's throwing him on the bus and begging him. And Ken said, Montel, call me and I'll serve. Then you add to that a person like Admiral Straw, a logistician. You need to get supplies where they belong. Right?
Right.
This is the problem. Medications, the guys who need it, you need somebody who understands Admiral Straw.
Listen, I agree with you. Remember, this is all a paperwork nightmare. Montel, I'm going to have to leave it right
there. They won't even talk to me. So if you go, Montel_Williams, #VA Surge.
VA Surge, hashtag it. All right, Montel.